How to increase semen volume is a big topic on YouTube. Yeah, there are some things you can do to achieve that, but the basic problem is the aging process is like a hole in a bucket full of water. It may make more sense to plug that hole instead of turning on the water, and trying to increase semen volume is more like turning on the water. So in this video, I will explain to you why semen volume is decreasing with age and why it no longer is squirting out with ejaculation, but loses its force until it merely drips out. In another video, I will give you some tips what you can do to counteract that. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. If you want to find answers to questions which are rarely addressed on the internet, then subscribe to UroChannel and give the video a thumbs up. Here's what happens with age in an otherwise healthy man who doesn't need any medication. Because certain health conditions, surgery, and medication may have a profound impact upon ejaculation and semen volume. First, let us have a look at the anatomy. The prostate and the seminal vesicles are important for the production of the seminal fluid. 95% of what comes out at ejaculation stems from these organs. Sperm cells are only produced in the testicles and mixed with the seminal fluids in the emission phase. I'm going to tell you in a second what that is. If we compare the male genital tract with a gun, and ejaculation is the shot that's fired, then the ejaculate is the bullet part of the cartridge, and the pelvic floor muscles act as the propelling and bursting charge. The most important of these muscles is the bulbospongiosus muscle, which is tightly attached to the fibroskeleton of the penis. This muscle covers the underside of the root of the penis from both sides, and in a sense, it is wrapped around the penis, but at the same time also rooted in the midline. Together with other muscles of the pelvic floor, it involuntarily contracts upon ejaculation. So actually, ejaculation and orgasm are subdivided into several components. First, there is the so-called emission phase. The seminal fluids from the seminal vesicles, the prostate, and the testicles are deposited in the posterior urethra. They get there by smooth muscle contraction within the prostate, the seminal vesicles, and the vas deferens. This phase is felt as the point of no return, where ejaculation becomes inevitable. It takes about 1 to 2 seconds prior to the ejaculation itself. Now the bulbospongiosus muscle, together with the pelvic floor, and in young men also the anus, start to contract rhythmically. The feeling of orgasm accompanies these contractions. In young men, there are 3 to 7 forceful contractions. The bulbospongiosus muscle is supposed to act as a pump during ejaculation. With contraction, it empties the deposited ejaculate from the urethra. With relaxation, it creates a sucking action, with new ejaculate being sucked into the urethra. In other words, the better this muscle is able to contract and relax, the more forceful ejaculation will be, and the more ejaculate will be expelled because of the more efficient suction. The reflex is so powerful that ejaculate travels 30 to 60 centimeters through the air. Also, the muscles of the urethra are included in rhythmic contraction, which continue to do so in an irregular manner for a few seconds. All of this has to be coordinated with the bladder neck and the urinary sphincter. The bladder neck has to close, otherwise there would be retrograde ejaculation, and the sphincter muscle will have to open during the expulsion. During the aging process, ejaculation becomes weaker. The emission phase becomes shorter. The feeling of reaching the point of no return might even get lost. The pelvic floor contractions become weaker and fewer, resulting in less intense orgasmic pleasure. Men over 50 will notice a reduced power, with 15 to 30 centimeters being the average distance now. At the same time, semen volume will decrease. This will continue to a point when ejaculate is only seeping out and no expulsion force is present anymore. The number of contractions will decrease as well to 1 or 2. There is still a lot to discover regarding the anatomy and physiology of ejaculation. the role of benign prostatic hyperplasia that accompanies the aging process has not been clearly defined, because, as you will remember, prostatic smooth muscle will squeeze out ejaculate in the emission phase. In BPH, this may not be so easy anymore, so semen volume might be reduced as a consequence. Late-onset hypogonadism may also be something to consider, because the male reproductive tract needs testosterone for maintaining its function, including the production of ejaculate. So, what can be done about it? You can't beat aging, that's for sure. If there was a simple trick for that, I wouldn't reveal it to you, but charge every one of you at least what it costs to buy a ticket for a trip to space or two tickets to dive to the Titanic. However, you can prevent premature aging and you can increase ejaculatory and orgasmic power. I will give you that information for free in the next video. Why do I reveal the secret for free? Because it requires hard work from your side, and according to my experience, hardly anybody is interested in solutions like that. So it's not really for free. You'll have to earn that success. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.